Good morning, students. Welcome back to our computer class. Hope you all are fine. Today we are going to learn our fifth lesson, that is a list. Okay, students. So let us start our fifth lesson. Lesson number 5, list. What is a list? In this chapter, you will learn about ordered list and unordered list and block quotes. HTML supports several types of list elements that should be included within the body of the document. These elements may be nested, which means that one set of elements can be embedded within another set of elements. Understood, students? This way you can give list tag to your HTML page. Next, ordered list. An ordered list can contain either number, alphabet, letters or Roman numerical placed in front of or to the left of the text. Understood, students? Means with the help of order list, you can put number in front of your sentence, words or text. Those number will come in which form? It will come in a number, alphabet and letters or Roman numerical numbers. Okay, students, the different types of ordered list. 1. Arabic number, like a 1, 2, 3, 4. 2. A alphanumeric lowercase, that is A, B, C, D. 3. Capital letter A, alphanumeric uppercase. That means capital letter A, B, C, D, etc. 4. Roman numeral lowercase. That is I, double I, triple I, V. 5. Roman numeral uppercase. Okay, so I will come in a capital letter. Understood, students? This way you can type order list in a different way. Usage. OL type. Okay, OL type can be 1, lowercase a, uppercase a, I or capital letter I. For example, in tag, OL type equals to 1. Okay, bracket close. The order list tag begins. Again, open angle bracket L1, angle bracket close, item 1, close the L1 tag. Again, open L1 tag, item number 2, close the L1 tag. Then close the OL tag. The order list tag ends. Understood, students? And that L1 means that item number 1 and item number 2, these are the list of your product. The entire list should be enclosed between the OL and close OL tags. Each of the list items should begin with the L1 tag and end with L1 tag. The BR tag is implicit with each L1 tag. Understood, students? I have shown to you the example also how to write the order list coding to the HTML page. Now, can you see this window? When you type the order list, you will get like this result. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The number has come. This is the order list. And after the सब्जेक्ट नेम हैज कम इंग्लिश साइंस सोशल साइंस मैथ्स हिंदी मराठी लाइक दिस रिजल्ट यू विल गेट ऑन अ वेब पेज व्हेन यू टाइप द ऑर्डर लिस्ट कोडिंग फॉर योर होम HTML. Next, on ordered list. When you wish to display an unordered list, which means a list in no particular order, you can create a bulleted list, which you enclose the entire list between the UL and close UL tags, and each of the list items within the L1 and close L1 tags. The list is displayed with bullets. Understood, students? You learn numbering and bulleting. Okay? Now, what you learn in order list? With the help of order list, you can put the number in front of your words or sentence. And with the help of unordered list, you can put the bullet. That is a different types of signs of bullets. Okay? So, below the diagram, can you see this diagram? In that side diagram, I will show to you the examples of subject name. In front of the subject name, can you see the bullets I have given to you? Okay? The dots are there, not a number. So, if you want to give the dots instead of numbers or alphabet, you can use the unordered list. Understood? Next, nested list. Sometimes when you display additional information about an item in a list, you need to create another list within the main list. This is called a nested list. That means when we give the contents, okay, for example, I want the fruits, okay? This is my content, this is a main content, and below that content I want to give the name of the fruits. What is that? For example, apple, orange, banana, etc. So that apple, banana and orange, it is known as a nested list. Understood, students? Okay, HTML provides you with the facility of being able to create nested list in your document. The nested list can be created simply by using nested UL and OL tags with list items. Understood? Okay. Now, in this diagram, I have shown to you the nested list. Contents I have given to you. In front of contents, bullets are there. Introduction, about us and contact us. Okay? And below the about us content, I have given the sub-contents like A, storybooks, B, textbook. These storybooks and textbooks is known as a nested list. Understood, students? What is a nested list? Okay, now next, block quotes. To separate a section of text from the rest of the text on your web page, the block quote and close block quote is used. Okay, we want to give the separation of the text. First two text, after we want to leave the space. So, you can use this block quote tag in a HTML coding. Okay, now I am showing to you the window. In that window, can you see some lines are there? The first line, to separate a portion of text from the rest. Then 2-3 sentences are there, and in between, after 3 sentences, some space is left and another sentence has come. That is, when you serve others, you serve God. Okay? So, how you leave the space in between these two lines? With the help of block quote. code. Understood, students? This way you can give the coding to your HTML, to your HTML document. This way you can use the list option to make your web page. Understood, students? Okay, hope you have understood this lesson. Thank you.